Hello and greetings from Iceland. It is official now. Our little tourist volcano has ceased to be. The last signs of life were registered last Saturday, and now the line is flat. The last glowing lava rock has vanished into the black hole it left us, and the last drone has melted over there. So it's time to sell our stocks in the drone companies. But there are, however, good news out there for those of us who have this passion for volcanoes. Tourist exhibitions like we just had will be on and off for the next 200-300 years. And until the next one, I will be keeping you busy, showing you other strange things on the peninsula, since I have been filming a lot there lately. And today I want to invite you to see a cross-section of a volcano by the coast, since it's not as depressing as a dying volcano that only days ago seemed so joyful and full of energy. So let's not get stuck there. This isn't the first volcano to die on us, nor the last one. So today we will celebrate its memory with a glimpse into the past, starting with a map of the Reykjanes Peninsula, since this part of Iceland is less than 100,000 years old, and this is the Krýsuvík volcanic system that stretches all the way into Reykjavík, almost coast to coast, and the south coast will be our main destination today. But those cliffs are not just among the best bird watching sites in Iceland. In this shot, I'm looking east, and this coast used to be my workplace for a while I was cod fishing along those cliffs. And while I was fishing there, 20 years of age, I didn't look at those cliffs as I do today, where we can read the history through the layers. I was actually more busy fighting seasickness and asking myself again and again, how did I get this idea? And spend a whole winter there by the cliffs, but they look better to me now. And as we get closer, we see this old crater better. It came into being most likely before the deglaciation, but there are just so many formations around here, so it can be difficult to find information about a small volcano like this one. And since I got a drone, it's easier to notice places like this. Those last 3 years with frequent earthquakes, they have been causing large chunks of the cliffs to fall down. So we better be careful when we do some hiking there. It's not completely safe. And as for tourism, the road down here from the South Coast Road is a bit lame. And in the background, we can see the Seltún Hot Springs by Lake Klevarvatn. That used to be the main attraction before the eruption in 2021. And those cliffs can be a nice place to get away from the mass tourism. And even though this short eruption came to an end, this period of volcanism that started in 2021 is expected to last for up to 300 years. So we can expect more tourist eruptions, but we can also expect other eruptions, which are going to cause way more troubles due to lava, air pollution, and even asphalt, or if we will have a submarine eruption, which is considered probable. So I have made my last video for a while about this particular eruption. It might start again, let's not rule that out, but this seems to be over. So I want to remind you that I have a video in the making about the volcanoes around the city, and I just got back from Askja volcano, so I'm using the last summer month very well. And I'm going to finish this by mentioning my New Year prediction. I predicted that the unique situation could arise that we had two eruptions in the same year, and it would most likely be the Reykjanes Peninsula and the Grímsvötn volcano. And I still think that we will see some big events before the year is over, not necessarily Grímsvötn, but something way larger that we have been seeing on the Reykjanes Peninsula. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.